Today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is economy related multiple choice questions. You know, multiple choice questions sometimes we can see very simple format like ABCD format, and some MCQs we can see statement wise questions, that is two or three or maybe four statements are there. We needed to pick up right answer. But here my point is that to select correct answer from the options given, we need some actives. The first thing is that mind present should be there, and also read the questions very carefully. I think you got the point. Then also read options very carefully with your mind presence. Don't quick to try out the right answer, or that means, you know, don't jump into the option. Read the options and think twice before selecting the right answer or right option. That doesn't mean you spend lots of time. We have limited time. The time is limited. See, for KIS examination, you know, we have only 90 minutes per paper. For UPSC exam, it is 2 hours. Okay, so select the most suitable answer from the options given. Okay, then we can move with questions. I would like to discuss around 10 questions that I have taken from different areas like monetary policy techniques, GDP point of view, and also inflation or deflation and so on. Okay, I will explain why a particular option is right, and also explain why other options are not correct. That is very important. Then only we can get thorough knowledge about a particular area. Okay, you should also make revisions while you are studying. Revisions, that is the best and the most important strategy for clearing examinations. Okay.
You are watching Economy Related Multiple Choice Questions Series 1. Let us consider first question, that is, consider the following statements. Statement 1, purchasing power parity exchange rates are calculated by comparing the prices of the same basket of goods and services in different countries. Statement 2, in terms of PPP dollars, that is, purchasing power parity norms, India is the fifth largest economy in the world. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. Option D, neither one nor two. See, here we can see first statement is based on a concept, that is purchasing power parity, and that statement is also correct. We know that PPP will consider cost of living, that is, what is the purchasing power of the currency rather than how much currency you have. So first statement is correct, but second statement, you know, it is based on a current economy. That statement is wrong, because PPP dollars point of view, India is the third largest economy next to China and America. Please understand. Okay, they just here, you know, in PPP dollars, India is not the fifth largest economy. India is the third largest economy. But you know, that statement is correct if that ranking is based on nominal GDP point of view. You can understand, in nominal GDP ranking, India is ranked at fifth place. That is, our country surpassed United Kingdom and France in 2019. That is, you know, the correct order is that in nominal GDP point of view, USA is the number one country, China second, third one is Japan, fourth one Germany, and fifth one India, sixth UK, and seventh place secured by France. But in terms of purchasing power parity, you can see first rank goes to China and USA commander second, India is the third one, fourth country is Japan, Germany is the fifth one and Russia is the sixth one. Okay, now we can consider question number 2. Which one of the following issues the Global Economic Prospects report periodically? Option A, the Asian Development Bank. Option B, the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development. Option C, the US Federal Reserve Bank. Option D, the World Bank. What is the right answer? Of course, it is the World Bank. That is correct. Option is D. Okay, here you know, you just understand what are the major international institutions and their publications. You can see the slide in which I have added number of global institutions and their issues or publications. For example, you know, World Development Report, that actually done by World Bank. Similarly, World Environment Outlook, released by UNEP, United Nations Environment Programme. World Trade Report, that is done by WTO, World Trade Organization. And you also understand, you know, the latest publication of the World Bank, that is Human Capital Index. And another popular publication of the World Bank is, of course, it is Ease of Doing Business Report. So this type of questions we can expect, that is, you should focus on international institutions, their headquarters and their chiefs, and also their important publications. Okay, for example, you know, World Bank's Doing Business 2020 survey, that is very important, a current economy topic, where you can see India moves up 14 places to 63rd position in World Bank's Doing Business 2020 survey. That is also very important. You know, India was ranked at 77 in the 2019 World Bank's Ease of Doing Business report. You know, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had set the target for India to break into the top 50 ranking this year, 2019. But we got, you know, 63rd rank. Okay, now we can consider third question. Here, you know, monetary policy technique related question. We can read. An increase in the bank rate generally indicates that. Option A, market rate of interest is likely to fall. Option B, central bank is no longer making loans to commercial banks. Option C, central bank is following an easy money policy. Option D, central bank is following a tight money policy. Here you know the right option is D. That is, central bank is following a tight money policy or dear money policy. It is a part of contractionary monetary policy technique of the central bank to combat or to control or regulate inflation. Understand? So we can consider option A, market rate of interest is likely to fall. It is absolutely wrong. When bank rate increased by the RBI, what will happen to the market rate of interest? Definitely market rate of interest will be increased. Okay, that is bank rate. You know what is bank rate? Bank rate is the rate of interest charged or imposed by the central bank while providing loans or credits to commercial banks. Then what is the market rate of interest? When me or you takes loan from the SBI, then SBI or other commercial banks impose or charge a particular interest rate upon us. That interest rate is known as market rate of interest. Sometimes, you know, bank rate is also known as discount rate. So when bank rate increases, definitely it will enhance the market rate of interest. So option A is wrong. What about option B? Central bank is no longer making loans to commercial bank. It is also wrong, because you know, central bank is ready to give loans to commercial banks, but when bank rate increases, the cost of rising loan for commercial banks will be increased. Okay, see, central bank is following an easy money policy. Never. It is incorrect, because central bank is following dear money policy, not quantitative easing policy. Okay, so the right option is D. Now we can consider fourth question. The lowering of bank rate by the Reserve Bank of India leads to option A, more liquidity in the market. Option B, less liquidity in the market. Option C, no change in the liquidity in the market. Option D, mobilization of more deposits by commercial banks. What is the right option? Option A is correct, more liquidity in the market. At the same time, option C, no change in the liquidity in the market, also correct. Why? See, bank right now is realigned with MSF, marginal standing facility. The day-to-day liquidity adjustment actually done by the RBI in India by using repo rate. Okay, day-to-day adjustment or short-term adjustment, that is actually done by RBI by using what? Repo rate, not bank rate. Bank rate, it is actually now a penal rate that is imposed on long-term borrowing. That is when commercial banks takes long-term loan, then RBI imposes bank rate. So, okay, in terms of theoretical point of view, when we read a standard textbook, option A is correct. Why? When bank rate decreases, the market rate of interest will be decreased. That will lead to what? Higher liquidity in the market. Okay, but see, in terms of current economy or economy point of view, what is happening today in India? That is, we are using, or RBI is using, its key policy rate. What is the key policy rate? Now it is repo rate. So option C also correct. You can opt either A or C, and see, we can just look at the option B, less liquidity in the market. It is absolutely wrong. Okay, no confusion. What about option D, mobilization of more deposits by commercial bank? That is also incorrect. Why? When bank rate decreases by the RBI, definitely commercial bank will decrease market rate of interest. Okay, market rate of, that is SBI imposing lower rate of interest on loan, definitely SBI or other commercial bank will decrease the rate of interest on deposit. We know that the profit of the commercial bank is the difference between the rate of interest imposed on loans and the rate of interest offered to depositors. Okay, so when SBI cuts the interest rate on loans, definitely they will cut the interest rate on deposits. Then lower rate of interest means less attractive to depositors to save their money with the bank. So option D is incorrect. Okay, I think you got the point. Now, fifth question. Priority sector lending by banks in India constitutes the lending to option A, agriculture, option B, micro and small enterprises, option C, weaker sections, option D, all of the above. Here, you know, the right option is D. You should refer to that area, priority sector lending, you know, in which RBI stipulates that what each and every commercial bank, including foreign banks, and we can see some variations in the mandatory percentage of the loans to priority sector. The common thing is that 40% of the total credit should be given to priority sector areas like what? Agriculture, MSME, micro, small and medium enterprises, weaker sections, and also for education, export credit, housing, social infrastructure and others. There are 8 defined areas that come under priority sector lending that was popular since 1972. It is very important. So the bank loans are moving towards most important sectors of the economy. That is the logic behind priority sector lending. So here the correct option is D. Okay, all of the above. Now we can consider question number 6. Which of the following grants or grant direct credit assistance to rural households? We can see 3 variables. Statement, that is 1. Regional rural banks. 2. NABARD. 3. Land development banks. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. Option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, 1 and 3 only. Option D, 1, 2 and 3.
See, what is the right answer here? See, you can see 3 variables. One is regional rural banks. And second one is NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, which is the apex bank in agriculture, finance and rural development, you know. Third variable is what? Land Development Banks. Here, suppose you know, it is very easy to find out the right option because we should use elimination technique. You know, we have four options, and in this options, the right one is option C, that is 1 and 3. Here, suppose you don't know about the regional rural banks and the land development banks, but you know what is NABARD. Then you can easily find out the answer. How? Here we can use elimination technique. You know, NABARD is the apex institutions. That means this institution will give only refinancing to other banks, including commercial banks, regional rural banks, cooperative banks, land development banks. That is, me or you or some other households never get loan from NABARD directly. Similarly, suppose if you want to take loan from RBI, is it possible? Never. RBI will help other banks and that banks will assist us. For example, RBI will help SBI, then we can take loan from SBI. It is not possible to take loan from RBI or NABARD and some other apex institutions. That is your refinancing. Refinancing means apex bank like RBI or NABARD will give loans to other banks. What is direct credit assistance or finance? That means me or you, farmers, industrialists, entrepreneurs, exporters, they can take loan directly from commercial banks, regional rural banks and so on. So if you know NABARD is the apex institutions, you can eliminate option 1 where you can see NABARD, and you can also eliminate option B and option D. By using this technique, you can very easily took the right option, that is C. Okay,
now we can use consider question number 7. In the context of Indian economy, open market operations refers to option A, borrowing by scheduled banks from the RBI, option B, lending by commercial banks to industry and trade, option C, purchase and sale of government securities by the RBI, option D, none of the above. Here, you know, you should focus a term, market. In economics, market means is the place where buyers and sellers are contact with each other for what? To sell or to purchase something. Okay, for example, you know, diamond market. It is the market for buying and selling of diamond. Apple market. It is the market for buying and selling of apples. So here, you know, it is the financial market related question. It is also come under the monetary policy tools extensively used by the Central Bank of the World, including RBI, Federal Reserve System in the USA, etc. So here, you know, by reading the options, you can just pick up the right option, that is C, purchase and sale of government securities by the RBI. See, monetary policy techniques or tools, we will make a new video for that topic. It is very important. I will upload new video for these areas. Okay, now question number 8. Recently, RBI has transferred rupees 1.76 lakh crore surplus to the central government. Which of the following provisions of RBI Act 1934 entrusted the RBI to do that transfer? Option A, Section 7 of the RBI Act. Option B, Section 8. Option C, Section 35. Option D, Section 47 of the RBI Act 1934. Here, you know, very important question, current economy related questions. You know, we can see some debate or discussion is going on about the transfer of a surplus fund from the RBI to the government. Okay, here the right option is D, Section 47 of the RBI Act 1934. And you also understand, the thing is that actually this surplus transfer was based on the recommendations of the expert committee to review the extant economic capital framework of the Reserve Bank of India. This committee actually led by Bimal Jalan, you know, former RBI governor. Okay, the committee is very important. Please note the chairman of that committee is Bimal Jalan. The committee was constituted on December 26, 2018 as per the decision of the RBI Central Board on November 19, 2018. The surplus transfers to government will be recorded as a non-tax revenue in the government account. We know there are two major sources of public revenue to the government. One is tax sources, second one is non-tax revenue. See, this surplus that comes under what? Non-tax revenue. That we will discuss these topics under public finance. Okay. Now we can consider question number 9. Which one of the following statements is an appropriate description of deflation? Okay. Option A. It is a sudden fall in the value of a currency against other currencies. That is incorrect. Why? That statement is related to, you know, depreciation that is come under the external sector of the country. Okay. Option B, it is a persistent recession in both the financial and real sectors of economy. That is also incorrect. Why? That is come under the economic recession, meltdown and so on. Okay. Option C, it is a persistent fall in the general price level of goods and services. Okay. That statement is correct. Why? We can see deflation is just the opposite of inflation. Persistent decrease in the general price level, that is the key word for what? Deflation. Okay. Here, you know, value of money is increasing. That is, there is a sudden fall in the general price level. Deflation occurs in an economy when the negative inflation prevails over a long period. Now we can say option number D, it is a fall in the rate of inflation over a period of time. Don't be confused here. That is, this concept is known as disinflation. Okay, that is, disinflation means a reduction in the rate of inflation. Here, you know, the government takes measures to control high rate of inflation. Okay, so here the correct option is C. Now the last question, question number 10. Which of the following payers come under the liquidity adjustment facility of the RBI? Option A, repo and reverse repo rates. Option B, repo and bank rate. Option C, repo and MSF, that is marginal standing facility. Option D, CRR and SLR. Okay, here, you know, what is the right option? Simple. Liquidity adjustment facility or liquidity adjustment measures of the RBI, you know, clearly come under monetary policy techniques of the RBI, in which there are two tools. Okay, please understand, what are the two tools that come under liquidity adjustment facility? One is repo rate, second one is reverse repo rates. Okay, all other options are wrong. Liquidity adjustment facility includes what? Two measures or two techniques, repo and reverse repo rates. You know what is repo rate? Repo rate is the rate at which the central bank lends to banks. Reverse repo rate is the rate offered by the central bank to banks for depositing funds with it. Or reverse repo rate represents what? That is RBI borrowing from commercial banks. We will discuss all these topics in the coming videos. Okay. And now you can also refer to my book, Indian and Kerala Economy, which contains, you know, 1,000+ multiple choice questions with answer keys and explanations. Okay.
Yes, friends, we can conclude. I firmly believe that this video is highly beneficial for you. And you can visit my website, naushadchamara.in. And also, you can download PDF files, including slides, etc. And I will upload more videos on economics and economy. And I would like to upload more videos like this, multiple choice questions, on different topics of all these things will benefit you. And more than that, prepare well, do well, be confident and be diligent. And please subscribe my channel and share my videos. Okay, thank you. Bye.